Good evening and welcome to Mozilla Tamil Nadu's Force Week 3. And I hope you're all familiar with what is the theme we're going to work on this week. And I'm so excited about this week because we have something excited about Wiki Commons, and previously we had Wikipedia, and I think many of you had learned about how to edit on Wikipedia, and Tamil Wikipedia especially. So this week we'll be saying how to contribute towards an a very interesting project called Wikimedia Commons. And so first of all, I'd like to introduce myself. This is Luna Meenakshi, and I am a contributor in Mozilla. Tamil Nadu is an open source community where our vision is mostly to get aligned with Mozilla's vision on being open source and also working on open source based projects, and also more about making a healthier internet, and also that we from Mozilla Tamil Nadu came up with this initiative for doing this FOSS Weeks, wherein we've been trying to gather around more contributions in open source, not just only about Mozilla and tech, but then keeping a more wider respect towards other open knowledge movements as well. So so to all those who have been part of Mozilla Tamil Nadu and been contributing from the previous weeks, thank you for that. And we've been also monitoring a lot of good works in response. And for those who are new and to start their contribution journey from this week, very, very welcome. And let me do a little bit of housekeeping here. So that, you know, people understand what we gathered, and also a little bit about the speaker. So today we have Mr. Pawan Santosh, who's a very honorable and more significant person in the Wikimedia space. He's been contributing to Telugu Wikipedia since 2013 and has improved more than 1,000 articles. The Telugu Wikipedia is a community. It's a community of 6 or 7 people, and also has generated more than 24,000 articles per day. And since 2016, Pawan Santosh became the admin of the Telugu Wikipedia, and is also his articles are focused on gathering, from literature and books, and also he's a very significant film critic, and so he writes about more on films as well on the wiki, and he's been part of the Women's Strategy team, and he's also part of the global health working group of Wikimedia, and as a working group, he's also been part of this global event of Wikimedia, which happens every year, and it's called Wikimania. And he's currently working as a community manager of Quora, where Quora is introducing Telugu language also as part of its project, and he's basically managing the whole community there. And he's also chairperson of the Wiki Conference 2020, and he's basically formulating the ideas and things on how to put it together and make this a global event. So with regard to Wikimedia Commons, which we're going to see today, he has worked on copyrights with Indian perspectives, and also he's collaborated with other community members to relicense the works to CC BY. And the most highlighting thing which I want to tell here is that he's been conferred with one of the most esteemed award called former Raju Lakshmana Rao Vishishta Wikipedia Award 2015. And no doubt this man deserves this. And also on behalf of Mozilla TN, we wish him that he also would get more laurels in his life. And we are today extremely honored to have him today as part of the training. And once again, welcome to you, Mr. Pawan Santosh. And just a small reminder before I leave the platform to Pawan Santosh. So we have broadcasted on the message about the attendance link where you need to enroll your names and also your Mozilla profile and also the username of if you have a Wikipedia account. And you can type in your Q&As. It's on the left side of the panel where you can see the Q&A. And if you're okay in typing your questions out, you can. And towards the end of the session, we'll be trying to answer all the questions. And if in case you feel that you want to give your questions in the form of a voice, you can raise your hand and let us know, and we'll give you a chance to talk towards the end. It can be anything about the session or about the Mozilla TN or about the collaborations. And more, you will be also receiving information about the webinar through an email. So, not taking too much time, I would like to give the platform to Mr. Pawan Santosh to take over.
Thank you, Bhuvana, for introducing me, and thanks to Mozilla Tamil Nadu for giving this opportunity to interact with more enthusiastic people who wanted to become part of Wikimedia movement and also contribute to the whole fabric of open knowledge and free knowledge and openness in the internet. So as Bhuvana introduced me already with more adjectives than anyone ever used while introducing me, I would directly go to the topic that we are going to discuss today. So the topic we are going to discuss today is Wikimedia Commons. You might have heard about the Wikimedia Commons, or you might have never heard about the Wikimedia Commons, but I definitely think everyone here knows what Wikipedia is, at least. So I'm starting to share my screen, and we'll explain from there, like, what is Wikipedia and what is Wikimedia Commons, what Wikimedia Commons has to do with Wikipedia. Like, this is Wikipedia, you already know, everyone in the internet almost know what Wikipedia is. So Wikipedia is a free encyclopedia that was started in 2001. So, when we say free, it doesn't mean free in free beer. It does mean free in freedom. Like, you can copy the entire article and share it wherever you want. There are publications in Europe and America where people make physical copies of Wikipedia and they sell it. People do sell the Wikipedia in entirety, and that's okay, because Wikipedia is in a license where anyone can make copies, anyone can share it, anyone can use it, and anyone can do whatever they want with the content that is there in Wikipedia. So when Wikipedia started in 2001, there is a problem. The problem is Wikipedia started with a higher goal than what, so Wikimedia movement started with a higher goal than Wikipedia. Like, Wikipedia is a free encyclopedia, but what Wikimedia movement is for is to share entire knowledge in this world with every human being freely. So when we say entire knowledge in this world, it doesn't mean that only text format, the only article format will come under the knowledge. So there is much more than the knowledge that is there in articles, that is there in text. So how to make that bigger goal happen? There comes the remaining projects of Wikimedia movement, like So when Wikipedia is there, then next question is, are not the media part of the whole ecosystem of knowledge? Yes, media is also part of ecosystem of knowledge. We can so there is a saying which says that instead of 50 words, we can just share one photo or one image that conveys 50 or 100 words. So to make that happen, like to bring all the media into freely shareable platform, there comes the Wikimedia Commons. Like, let me show you this. So this is the Tamil language page of Wikipedia, in English Wikipedia. So I assume that this is Tamil. I don't know Tamil, sorry for that. So I assume that this word denotes Tamil. So I am opening it in next page. This is a photo, or this is a PNG. So this is Wikipedia and this is a PNG about Tamil. Do you think this PNG stays in Wikipedia website? Actually, no. This is actually there in Wikimedia Commons. See, this is a file from Wikimedia Commons. Information from its description page is there, is shown below. Let us click there. So almost most of the photos that we see in Wikipedia and most of the images that we see in Wikipedia are hosted in Wikimedia Commons. We generally don't know this. Wikimedia Commons is like a iceberg which is half drawn in the ocean. Like, we can only see Wikipedia. All the files that Wikimedia Commons do have, we will see it in Wikipedia in general. Like, let us come down. So this photo, let us open here, this image. So this is again is in Wikimedia Commons. So let us go for another photo. Tamil inscriptions in a pillar in a village. Tamil inscriptions on a pillar. So let us open description page. Again, this is in Wikimedia Commons. So in a way, Wikimedia Commons is providing a platform to share all the media files that are again free to be reused anywhere. So that is the reason why Wikimedia Commons do exist. Like, Wikipedia don't hold everything. There is another project called Wikimedia Commons which will hold all the media files that are there in freely usable format. So let me come to the point, what is free here? So why I am using this word called free? So there are two kinds of licenses that photos need to be there if you wanted to use that. First kind of license is, it should be in any of the free licenses. Like, we have several free licenses, like Creative Commons free licenses. There are many, a list of free licenses that comes under Creative Commons free licenses. Or there will be a way, like after certain age, if photo gets certain age, like if photo was taken 60 years back and if get aged until 60 years, after 60 years in India, that photo loses its copyright. So no one holds its copyright. It is known as public domain image. So those kind of public domain images also can be there in Wikimedia Commons. And images which are in freely licensed can also be there in Wikimedia Commons. There are two ways. So this is a collection of freely usable media files to which anyone can contribute, like Wikipedia. This is Wikimedia Commons. So let me show you how to get into this. You either need to create an account. I assume you have an account. Let us go to directly login. I have an account and I am logging in. So now, what are the kinds of images that I can share in Wikimedia Commons? That's the first question. Why should I share in Wikimedia Commons? That's the second question. Let us answer the latter question first. So let us see this list of photos that are featured. For example, let us see this photo. This is a picture of 2007, which is a winner of international competition run by Wikimedia Movement, Wikimedia Foundation. This is a winner of that competition. So let us see wherever this used. See, this file is used in these many pages. It was put in Wikimedia Commons, so it was used in these many pages. And then let us go here. These many Wikipedias, like af.wikipedia.org, ar-Arabic Wikipedia, and AST, I don't know this language, and az.wikipedia.org, ba.wikipedia.org, beta wiki wikiversity, beta bengali.wikipedia.org. So there are a list of articles. So there are hundreds of articles where this photo got used. Like, for example, let us see here. This was used actually here. So if you upload one picture to Wikimedia Commons, which is in freely licensed, that is either in public domain or in CC by SA or CC by license, then it will get used. It will be used in hundreds of pages, if possible in hundreds of pages, or at least in few pages of Wikipedia across the language versions. So let us go to my uploads. I have also uploaded several photos to Wikimedia Commons. I'll show you where my uploads got used. So let us take this page. S.V. Rangarao as Ravana. Open this page. See, this was uploaded by me, author Pawan Santosh. It's own work. Description: S.V. Rangarao as Ravana. He is a famous actor in Telugu, and I assume that he acted in many Tamil movies also. So there is a photo that was taken by me. I upload it here. So let us see, it was not been used anywhere. That's okay. Let us go to another page. If it got used anywhere. So S.V. Rangarao in Maya Bazaar. Ghantasala Venkateswar Rao statue in Guntur. So see, it was used in Telugu Wikipedia, S.V. Rangarao page, and also another few pages, and there is in a Japanese Wikipedia. I have never thought of. So this is Japanese Wikipedia. There is a Mayabaja article in Japanese Wikipedia. Here, the photo that was published by me was used by Japanese Wikipedia article about Maya Bazaar. So this is the way it can reach. Like, if you have a photo, like this is another photo that was taken by me. This is a singer's statue in Guntur. He's a Telugu singer in Guntur. It was used in English Wikipedia Ghantasala Venkateswar Rao page. So his biographical article page, it was used there. So in a way, what I wanted to say, if you ever wanted your picture, you may have clicked several pictures, picture of a place, like if you have went to some Ooty or Kodaikanal, some place, there will be a lot of natural beauty. You might have for your enjoyment, and you might have shared it in Facebook, somewhere else, anywhere in the internet. But if you upload that to Wikimedia Commons, that can be used many places in the internet, not just here. I'll show you some other example also from my own experience. Like in 2016, let me dig back. I have uploaded several photos. We are in 2018 October. So I'm going to next page. We are still in 2018, 2017. Next page. So we are still 2017. So 2016, I have ATM. So see this picture. This is just an ATM queue. This is not a, but there is a history behind this ATM queue. This is a queue in ATM at Tadepulligudem, that is my native place. After demonetization of Indian 500 and 1000 rupees note, I have just went out to use ATM and get some money. I was shocked because there are many people. I have never seen such a queue in any of the ATMs before 2016. Demonetization happened. So quickly I have taken this photo and this became a part of history, and I uploaded it to Wikimedia Commons, and it was used in 500 and 1000 rupees demonetization page in Telugu. So this is not just one case. If we check it in the internet, it was being used in many international media. Actually, I have seen it. So the picture that was clicked by me in a place like Tadepulligudem was used many international media to tell their stories. Like, they don't have a reporter in India, especially in a mid-level town in Andhra Pradesh. So effectively, the license here, the license is you are free to share, to copy, distribute and transmit the work, to remix, to adapt the work under the following conditions, attributions. You must give appropriate credit, provide a link to license and indicate if changes were made. You may also do so in any reasonable manner, but not in a way that suggests the licensor endorses you or your use. That's the first condition. Attribution is needed. And second one, share alike. If you remix, transform or build upon the material, you must distribute your contributions under the same compatible license as original. Like, proprietary, I cannot restrict people to share it and remix it as I do just because they have changed something or tweaked something. So effectively, this license is allowing people to share and remix as they like, if they give proper attribution to me and also Wikimedia Commons, and also they are sharing in the same license. So this is the whole logic. This is the whole license behind license that allows this photo to be reused in international media or anywhere else. Like, if someone wants to, in 2030 or 2040, someone wants to create a small educational material to show in a classroom, this license will allow them to do so. But if I publish this in Facebook, if I publish this in Twitter and nowhere else, then licenses are with me, so it effectively says anywhere out of the Twitter, no one can actually use it. It is true that people are using it outside the Twitter without even giving appropriate attributions. That is illegal. But here, if we publish in Wikimedia Commons, that is allowing this photo to be used as a educational material, as a photo to represent something, as a part of human knowledge. Anyone is free to use it again, any time, like not just in 2016, 2017, 2020, 2030, anywhere in the near future. So in one way, it will give you proper attribution. In another way, it will also give you a satisfaction that your photos, your personal gallery is also doing some favor to this world. It is also building up some knowledge of the world. So, first point, why should we contribute to Wikimedia Commons? That's precisely what we have discussed right now. So now, coming to the second part, how can we contribute to Wikimedia Commons? What are the pictures that we can contribute to Wikimedia Commons? Of course, I assume most of us got convinced that for the idea that we need to contribute to Wikimedia Commons. We need to contribute photos to Wikimedia Commons, pictures to Wikimedia Commons. So what are the photos that I can contribute to Wikimedia Commons or pictures that I can contribute to Wikimedia Commons? Let us see it right now. So this will be a second part of this. Like, you have been logged in and now click upload. You will get this upload wizard. Now you need to initially learn. You are doing it right now, and then upload. Share. So go to your download. Sorry. So go to your media files and check something. I have many photos in my media files. Let us click something like Dasaraja Rangacharlu. He is a famous writer. Let us open that picture and try to upload it. So then next comes the major critical question. This site requires you to provide copyright information for this work to make sure everyone can legally reuse it. So when you are putting it, when you are uploading a photo to Wikimedia Commons, in a way you are allowing people to reuse it. So to reuse a photo, you need to either have that photo as your own, or there should be some logic behind why it can be reused. So first one, is it my own work? I, Pawan Santosh, dot as the copyright holder of this work, irrevocably grant anyone to right to use this work under the Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike 4.0 license. Leave all the jargon here. Let us focus on one thing. I, Pawan Santosh, dot as the copyright holder of this work. Am I the copyright holder of this work? Of course not. I'm not a painter. I cannot paint such a beautiful picture. So this is not the right option. The second one, this file is not my own work. Source xyg.com. Author, some painter, xyz painter. Next, another question. Now tell us why you are sure you have the right to publish this work. The copyright holder published this work with the right Creative Commons license. If it is the case, see, Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike 4.0. Did copyright owner publish that under Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike 4.0? I don't know. I don't know under what license that copyright owner do published it. So then it comes the next point. The copyright holder published their photo or video on Flickr with the right license. So in the Flickr, so you know there is a website called Flickr. In that Flickr website, anyone can publish their own work under different licenses. There will be different licenses code. If copyright's owner published it either under CC BY SA 2.0 or CC BY Creative Commons Attribution 2.0 or original work of US federal government, if any of these licenses, then you can opt this. No, I don't know that also. The copyright has definitely expired in USA. Why? What is the reason? First published in United States before 1925? It can be the one reason. No. First published before 1925 and the author deceased more than 70 years? No. Faithful reproduction of a painting in public domain because author died more than 70 years ago? No. So this is also not the case. This work was made by United States government? No. It is also not the case. Another reason not mentioned above. I found it on internet is the right reason. In a way, I cannot publish this work. What I wanted to explain you is, there are some laws that govern the whole business of Wikimedia Commons. So there are some laws, copyright laws, that govern whole Wikimedia Commons. We need to understand under what are the works that we can publish. So if that work is yours, like you have painted something very beautiful, unlike me, you are a good painter. In that case, you can take that picture and you can upload it to Wikimedia Commons, and there ends the matter. You can just select first option, like this is my own work. There ends the whole story. That's okay. If that is not the case, then either it should be a picture, a photo clicked by you, like with your mobile or with anyone else's mobile. If you click that, also you will be the copyright holder. The person who clicked that photo will be copyright holder of that photo. Let us explain it in a funny way. For example, if I wanted to publish my marriage photos, the thali that I perform or pujas that I do perform to Wikimedia Commons. So I spent almost 110,000 rupees on photographer for my marriage photos to be clicked. In a way, we think that we own those photos, right? Everyone feels that my marriage photos are my own or joint property of me and my wife. So, but the point is, according to any government's copyright laws, as far as I know, take it Indian government or US government or European sphere, photographer holds the copyright law. Photographer is the copyright owner of that photo. The person who clicked that photos. If you wanted to be copyright owner of that photos, you initially need to have an agreement signed by your photographer saying that all the copyrights that I get out of this entire business, like out of this commission, rests with XYZ person, like Pawan Santosh Swarampudi. You need to ink that one. He need to sign it in a proper government agreement. So proper government issued paper note or something. So naturally, a person who clicked the photo will have copyright. So your gallery, not your selfies or something. If you clicked something like Meenakshi Amman temple in Madurai, or if you clicked something like a fruit vendor in Chennai, or if you clicked some photo of something in Sri Lanka, some place or something, which can be part of knowledge. Don't underestimate the vast hands of the knowledge. So knowledge goes so long. Like so that if you click some if you click a food item like Saravana Bhavan idli and sambar, that is also part of the knowledge, because Saravana Bhavan is a notable place and idli and sambar is so notable. You have Wikipedia pages, I guess, for idli also. So if you click something like some jasmine, that also part of knowledge, because jasmine, I don't know exact botanical name of the jasmine, but on botanical name of the jasmine there will be Wikimedia pages in many languages. So take anything that is so useful, that is at least useful, place, river or village, a scene or people walking around, or celebrities like Stalin, Rajnikanth, you have seen somewhere on road or in some public function. If you have such photos clicked by you, you can effectively upload those photos to Wikimedia Commons directly, just by saying, so this is not the picture that was clicked by me. Oh, yes, this might be the picture that was. Okay, I have. So, it is taking few seconds. Let us wait for it. Don't forget, now we are discussing about first part of how to contribute to Wikimedia Commons. But first part is your own pictures, your own photos. You might be painted it, or you might have clicked it, or else you have created it using some graphics tool, vectors tool, something. In some way, you are the creator of that photo. Those kind of photos you can upload to Wikimedia Commons. That photo need to be this my own work. Now, I, Pawan Santosh.S, the copyright holder of work, irrevocably grant the right to use this under the Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike license. This is legal code. Next. Then you need to give a unique title, descriptive title. I actually forgot what it is. Let us say, I'm not going to upload it. Just for the sake of explanation, I'm explaining this one. Congregation, pardon me, my spellings are wrong. Congregation in Hyderabad. It should be much more specific actually. Congregation in Abids, Hyderabad, for example. So you can give caption in English or you can give caption in Tamil. I don't know how to type Tamil, pardon me for that. Then description. Congregation of people about XYZ event in Hyderabad, Abids, XYZ grounds, Hyderabad. It was clicked in so and so date. Photo already have metadata actually. So from that metadata, it was already collected it. 2019-11-6, it was the date. So categories, Hyderabad. Sorry, public meetings in Hyderabad. There is no such thing. Meetings in Hyderabad, India. Yeah, it's in India. Publish file. Okay, skip this step. So this is the way you can publish something. Okay, so this is the way you can upload something. I need to tag it for remove deletion because I mistakenly uploaded it. Sorry to Wikimedia Commons administrators for burdening you with more work. So this is one way you can contribute to Wikimedia Commons. Like, I will show my uploads that I have already made right from the beginning. So for example, this is an interesting photo, you can see it. So there is a famous temple in Jubilee Hills, Hyderabad. Its name is Paddam Temple. So this guy is a politician. His name is PJR and he is so quite famous in Hyderabad. This guy died. He is patron of this temple. So the latter committee decided to put his statue behind near the temple in this way, like in temple Torana. This guy's statue was bust statue was being put. this is one photo that I have uploaded. There are many such photos you can upload. There is another way you can upload. This is the first way, like photo that you have created. Second way is photos that those which copyright got expired. Like copyright is not a permanent right. So for example, this is my in-laws house, my father-in-law, and it will be inherited by my wife, and my wife gives this property to her daughters or sons or sales it up to other people, and they will sell it up or they will give it to their children and grandchildren. That is how property goes on. You all know that. But copyright is not such right. Copyright also can be inherited by offspring, like, or copyright also can be inherited by sons and daughters and grandsons and granddaughters. But there will be a limit for a copyright to be enjoyed. Like, for example, if a photo was clicked in 1950, or a movie was produced in 1950 and movie was screened in 1950, then that movie and that photo are clicked on. So for example, let us take this movie, this movie, Nadodi Mannan, sorry for my pronunciation. It was directed by M.G. Ramachandran, and it is his debut movie. So it was released in 1958 to 2020, already 60 years are gone. After 60 years, according to Indian copyright law, this movie is now in public domain. It cannot be under copyright law. So it cannot be governed in copyright law, and it cannot be, so whoever the offspring of Mr. M.G. Ramachandran cannot enjoy the copyright law, cannot enjoy the copyright of the movie right now. So anyone screen this movie, anyone can reuse this movie, anyone can do whatever they want with this movie. Effectively from 2019 January 1st, that is according to Indian copyright law. Same applies to the photos. So if some photo was clicked on 1958, then right now it is under public domain. Anyone can use it. So you can also contribute public domain photos to Wikimedia Commons. For an example, I have uploaded several photos of, for example, let me show you this one. So this is a photo from 1890, plague affected patient being carried on manually propelled ambulance at Wadi Bandar Hospital, Bombay in 1890. Of course, 90 years, more than 90 years, more than 120 years, almost 20 years back photo. It has no copyright. No one can claim its copyright. It is under public domain. So I uploaded this photo under public domain licensing. See, this is licensing. I will show you how to do it. Just a minute. This is aerial view of Taj Mahal, 1940. Let me save it. Aerial view of Taj Mahal, 1940. So I have downloaded it. Now I am using the same upload button. Select media files. Continue. This is my own work. No, I have not born by 1940. This is not my own work. Source, I will give this Indian History Pick link, author unknown, because this guy has not shared any author's name, photo, Hensley photo library. It is not author's name, it is just in a library, photo library. I am putting it unknown for now. So why do I think this is under public domain? Another reason not mentioned above, come here, flower brackets open, PD, capital PD, INDIA, flower brackets close. This piece of code, you should remember this piece of code. Let us show, see. It shows up like this. It effectively says the copy applies here to works first published in India. This was first published in India, I guess. Yes. And according to Indian Copyright Act 1957, anonymous works, photographs, cinematograph works, sound recordings, government works, and works of corporate authorship or of international authorship enter the public domain 60 years after the date on which they are first published, counting from the beginning of the following calendar year. So this is 1940. It was definitely public, under public domain. So I am using this piece of code and I'm going next. Aerial view of Taj Mahal, 1940, English. You can actually add another language and put Tamil and write whatever that is applicable. And in the description, aerial view of Taj Mahal from in 1940 from, sorry, Hensley photo library. Okay, so we have to manually enter date 1940. That is what we have. Taj Mahal. That is the category I am giving. Publish file. So now this was published. You already gave, you have contributed this one, this content. Like skip this step. So this can be used anywhere in the internet. Like use this file, you can copy page file URL, or use this file in a wiki. You can copy this content and you can publish somewhere where you want. Like for example, I am, for time being, I am publishing it in my user page. This is user page. So it shows up like this. I think all of you felt a bit of happy for so when I first learned about Wikimedia Commons, I felt very happy that I can be able to contribute to photos of Wikimedia movement. I started going cycle tours, bike tours to many villages in my circle. Like I came from a place called West Godavari district in Andhra Pradesh. That is a beautiful place. I used to go to cycle tours, and with a small mobile, and I used to pick every place, and I used to take several pictures of the places, and I used to upload that to Commons, Wikimedia Commons. That actually helps. And I also used to upload pictures of great people statues, and I went to a museum and I took a permission from museum by paying some nominal fees of 40 rupees or 30 rupees for photography, and I have taken all the pictures and I uploaded them to Commons like this. And I felt it so amusing to be able to contribute to such a great project. So this was like, I felt very nice. I have recorded a historical movement now we cannot do it going back in the history. Like, cannot go back in time and do it again. So, like, see, this is one chat I have photographed. This statue can be used in this guy's page. Like P. Janardhan Reddy, he's a politician. These two pictures are clicked by me. This guy is no more, and no one can picture photograph him now. So, yeah, you can do many such things, and you can make use of your phone camera from now, or your whatever Porsche camera do you have from now. Like, this is table dosa. So this is so long dosa, so big dosa. I have taken a picture and I have published it in Wikimedia Commons, and it was used in English Wikipedia page of dosa. Like, go and see. I have my footprints in that page. I'll show you. So, table dosa, which covers almost half of the table. this is what I wanted to share with you. And sorry for my English. I acknowledge that my English is not so great. So right now I wanted to start Q&A session. I'm stopping to share my screen right now. You can post your question and answer. You can post your questions. So someone asked me a question that, hi Pavan, how can I attribute? So this is a flip side of this Wikipedia Commons business. Like, if you are using some photograph, someone else's photograph from Wikimedia Commons, how you can attribute? So I am again sharing my screen to show you how can we attribute. Hello. Table dosa photo in their blog or somewhere, they can use this photo. Like, they can use this file. There is an attribution here only. Like, you can copy it directly. Like, see, pavansantosh.s/cc-by-sa in bracket creative commons slash licenses by sa something something. So you can copy this one, and you can give link to this URL, and you can use it anywhere. Like, if you wanted to tweet it, you can. If you wanted to use this in a tweet, then you can download this photo and you can upload it in tweet, but provided you should use this you should do like this. So for example, you should put this small piece of text there. Pavansantosh.s is the original creator of this photo, or the person who needs to be attributed, something like this. So I would like to see, where can we get to know more about licenses? So more about licenses, I'll show you. Again, I'm sharing my screen. So to learn more about licenses related to Wikimedia Commons, anyone can contribute, freely usable. If you click freely usable, Commons licenses. So here in Commons licensing, you can read all the content about acceptable licenses. So these are the major rules. Republication and distribution must be allowed. Publication of derivative works must be allowed. Commercial use of works must be allowed. The license must be perpetual, non-expiring and non-revocable. Acknowledgement of all others or contributors of work may be required. So you can waive off your attribution. publication of derived works under the same license may be required. So licenses should be under these framework. So well-known licenses, they gave you public domain, CC0, CC by attribution, CC by SA. They gave you this table where commons licensing about, and you can go on reading this material. There will be a lot of material available regarding this here in this page. And you can also read this copyright rules by territory. If you want to get into more content about how copyright law works in different countries, you can read, you can explore this one also. So see, you can see life plus 100 years, brown color, Mexico, life plus 100 years. So life plus 60 years, light orange, India. Life plus 50 years, even light orange, all these countries. Life plus 70 years, these countries. So such kind of things do exist in Wikimedia Commons. The majority of this material will be available in this Commons licensing page. I am sharing this with you. So I shared it. Where can we know more about licenses? I shared it with you. So if I am using Wikipedia, do I need to mention your name? So Wikipedia also do require attribution. Like for example, if you are using a Wikipedia page, like if you are copying entire text from Wikipedia page, it requires a attribution. But you just need to attribute that this is from Tamil Wikipedia or this is from English Wikipedia. You don't need to attribute every person that has been who contributed to that page. So, but because that is a different licensing, you just need to say from Wikipedia or from English Wikipedia, from Telugu Wikipedia or from Tamil Wikipedia, and you just link to that page. That much attribution is required. So, but if you are using the photos in Commons, then you need to attribute the person who created that photo and also Commons as a platform. So any other questions? So Sridhar want to speak something and he raised his hand. As remaining questions got completed, like I have answered all the questions in Q&A tab. Can one or someone enable him to speak? Sorry, I could not. Hello.
Yes, Mr. Sridhar, you can speak.
Yeah, so before Sridhar speaks, I have some other questions that Srinivasan asked. So how to upload multiple photos? I'll start sharing again. I just started sharing full screen. Thanks for this tip, Srinivasan. So I'm clicking on the button upload. Select media files to share. Sorry. Again, I need to do it just for the sake of showing purpose. I don't have genuine files that need to be uploaded. So I can select like this with shift and selecting all with cursor and shift and open those files. Of course, these photos are not clicked by me. Okay, sorry. I just want to remove it. I'm not going to publish these photos. Continue. So to upload multiple photos, I either select three of these ones. These photos are of my own work. These photos are not my own work. Provide copyright information for each file individually. For example, if this file is my own work, for example, assume that this file is my own work and remaining two files are not my own work, then I need to opt this one and go for next. So, and then I need to have a descriptive titles, as I explained earlier. I need to provide descriptions and I need to release rights here. This is not my own work or this is my own work. And then a date, next one, and the next one. So if many of those photos do have the same kind of licenses or same description, for example, if you click 50 photos of Taj Mahal from different angles or from different times, like morning to afternoon, like 4 to 5 people, then for example photo sake caption description, I'm providing the same description. And there is something like you can select a date, for example, April 1st. And example category, example images. And then there is something like you can choose what is the information that you should copy for the remaining photos. Like if there are 50 photos, you don't need to go and change all the 50 photos and do that laborious work. You can simply copy it. Like photo for photo sake 02, photo for photo sake 03, and all the information will be copied. Under the same date, you can also select a location. I'm not going to publish the files and I'm not going to repeat the mistake. So this is the way you can contribute to commons multiple photos at a time. And there is also an app for Android. This page. So there is a mobile app for Android. One can use that Android app, like the Commons app is maintained. So you can see it here. Right now I cannot show it. You can download that app from your Play Store and you can start contributing to Wikimedia Commons from your mobile directly. Like it will be more easy. Like you don't need to bring all the photos from mobile to Wikimedia to your system and then upload. You can via your app. These are several photos that were uploaded from the app, like protest in Kerala, explorer, civil rights activist Irom Chanu Sharmila. All these photos got uploaded using that app. Some files don't show up the use this file option. At that time, I need to download and upload the same without any correction under this is not my work, where or which column I need to attribute. Some files don't show the use this file option. At that time, I I need to download and upload the same without any correction. I didn't get the point. So, can you explain a bit more? So the next question is, can I upload any photo, for example, some 100 images of my recent school friends gathering photos? So initially I have explained about that a bit, but I need to explain it elaborately. For example, you are seeing one of my property in my house. If it is not part of the knowledge, human knowledge, you don't need to upload it, like your cot or 100 images of my recent school friends gathering photos, or your selfie every day. For example, in Instagram, you will upload selfies and thousands of photos that about your friends and all. You should not upload those photos. Photos should be useful. Photos should be part of the knowledge. For example, if one of your schoolmates is somehow popular or is notable enough to have a page in Wikipedia, probably you can upload his photo to Wikimedia Commons, which will be very useful. Or else, if you go to some Tamil writers congregation or some Tamil movie function, then you will find several celebrities who already do have pages in Wikipedia, and there might not be their photos in Wikipedia or Wikimedia Commons. So clicking their photos and uploading them to Commons is a good idea to do it. Like, it should be part of the human knowledge. You cannot upload anything. It is not a social media platform. So what are the not to do items, Srinivasan? So when you are contributing to Wikimedia Commons, first thing you should not do is you should not upload something that you find in internet and you don't know about any license or anything. Like, you cannot upload the meme that you like most, or you cannot upload a random photo of Amitabh Bachchan that you found on internet. You cannot upload someone else's property. There is a proverb in Telugu which says that son-in-law donates mother-in-law's property. So son-in-law cannot donate mother-in-law's property. One should donate their own property in general. That's the logic. So you can see photo that was clicked by you. You cannot relicense someone else's work. That's first not to do thing. If you don't know the license properly, you should not upload it. And second one, you cannot randomly upload every photo that you clicked. My mobile has hundreds of photos of my niece and my nephew. I should not upload them to Wikimedia Commons, but because if you upload them to Wikimedia Commons, you cannot remove them. Probably you cannot remove them without taking some pain, without asking some help from an organizer. So you should not upload some photo that is not useful and that also violates personal rights. Like, if other person don't want to appear their photo in any public platform, you cannot click their photo and upload it to Wikimedia Commons. So these are major not to do things. So yeah, there is another question. Sorry to organizers for taking this last question. If we plan for a photo walk around my city, what are the things to note, what to capture in the city and what not? Like, We should be felt very happy because in India there is something called panorama freedom. Like in India, if you go to any European city, you cannot do a photo walk randomly and click every place, because in European cities there will be something called in most of the European countries copyright to an architecture, like a building do have a copyright and the architect holds that copyright. So but in India we have a panorama freedom. If you walk on the road, if you find some building, you can photograph it. You don't, no one is stopping you to take a picture, but you need to keep something in your mind. It should be useful. Like if you are going on a road, you can click photos of statues that you see. There are many famous people who got statues of their own in Tamil Nadu or any place in India, any town in India. You can click those statues and you can upload those statues to Wikimedia Commons. That is one good thing you can do. And if you are going through a heritage place, like if you are walking in a Chennai, some heritage place in Tamil Nadu or something, those relevant to heritage and all, and you can upload them to Wikimedia Commons. And you can click photos related to culture. For example, if I am conducting a photo walk in Hyderabad Abids, there will be Irani Chai, a very famous Irani Chai, where there will be a very different way to brew that chai. You can click that Irani Chai photo and you can put it into Wikimedia Commons. That also is a kind of service. And you can click photos related to places of worship, which will be somehow used in some Wikimedia project. There are such things that you can do. Like it can be related to culture, it can be related to some kind of knowledge. If you are going through a park, for example, you can click n number of photos related to trees, related to flowers, related to many such things, many such botanical things, and you can label them properly and you can upload to Wikimedia Commons. So it should be related to somehow related to knowledge. I gave some of my ideas. This is not an ideal, I didn't explain you an ideal photo walk, but you can use your creative freedom to think, and you can find, you can search Wikipedia pages regarding that city and find out where are the gaps of where is the gap in the whole knowledge. So I saw some images in English Wikipedia article, but there is no option for use file option. How can we use those images in Tamil Wikipedia? So I have shown you, you should go to Wikimedia. You should not go to Wikimedia. So this is a bit of jargon. You need to explore, dig more into it. There is something called fair use. In English Wikipedia, many of the photos related to film personalities are related to many of the photos related to posters are uploaded under fair use. Right now I cannot explain the term fair use, and I cannot go on explaining copyright aspects related to it, because session is going to end very soon. Search for something called fair use in Wikimedia Commons and you will get it. Sorry for this. I will share the link about that. Hello Pawan, how do we know our photos were used by someone else or maybe by some website? Just to know our pictures, that is helpful for someone. So if it is I have shown you in the down of the picture, you count picture in one section, you will see in how many Wikipedias your photo is being used. So for an example, entire screen. Hello. So for an example, come down here, files usage on other wikis, you will see these two photos. So for other than Wikimedia here you will see only files used in other wikis and Wikimedia Commons, not anywhere else. Like if you want to see in how many places in the internet your photo is being used, you should definitely download that photo and upload it in Google reverse search engine. There is something called images.google.com or something. There is a reverse Google search. You can use photo search and you can find it out. There is no other way. And thanks everyone for your questions, and thanks everyone for coming to this session. And now I am handing this platform to co-organizer Bhavana.
Thank you very much, Mr. Konsantosh, for this. And we have also unmuted Mr. Sridhar at this point, so he can let us know if in case he wants to talk and wants to get anything in detail, or later that if he wants, like, he can follow up through emails as well. So, Sridhar, do you want to take it? Alright, with that note, thank you very much again, Mr. Pawan Santosh, for taking your time, and also for taking us through the whole of Wikimedia Commons. And of course, I had also been doing a bit of my contribution on Wikimedia Commons, but I didn't know extremely, like, the meaning of the contributions, and for the more intricate details about attribution and licenses. But then it was definitely wholesome of knowledge gathering from this particular event. So thanks again for your time, and also to all the attendees who attended this particular event. Hope it had been valuable for you as well. I just request you to mark in your attendance in the sheet that's provided, and that we would be sending a post email, and this particular video will also be uploaded in our YouTube channel, so Mozilla TM YouTube channel. So further, if you want to refer back and want to see how to contribute further, we can do it. And also we'll be soon forming a group on any of the social media, and you can of course join and be guided directly by Konsantosh, or likewise any of the Wikimedians. So yeah, with that we end today's first week, and stay tuned for the next week. We'll be coming out with a similar kind of an exciting free open source knowledge projects. So thank you everyone. Bye. Have a great weekend.